produces energy and it transplants it into here. We've been working on things that have to do with energy. So like renewable energy sources and non-renewable energy sources, energy storage, energy usage, and like stuff like that. Red, orange, yellow.
Harmony Goodwin-Kinney is a fourth grader at Wadsworth STEM Elementary in Woodlawn.
Here's our code. I designed a carousel that spins one direction 10 times, it pauses, and then spins the other direction 10 times, and it keeps doing that.
300 students from kindergarten through high school in CPS robotics programs had the opportunity to showcase their work at the Museum of Science and Industry.
We want our students to be creators and not just consumers of technology.
Chris Beck is the district's director of computer science.
So this is a program we are really trying to scale in every neighborhood and every school. We want our students to have access to computer science, and robotics makes it physical and tangible and touchable. And so it is a way that they can see the thinking that they're doing in programming and computer science physically play out with a robot.
My favorite aspect of it is kind of designing intricate parts of the robot, like designing the mechanisms.
Halima Adegbite is a part of the team at Lindblom Math and Science Academy that just competed in the World Robotics Championships. She's headed to the University of Michigan to study mechanical engineering and focused on showing younger girls the possibilities in STEM fields.
Well, as a young Black woman, I feel that it's important to see people in order to become those same people. And so I feel like I'm on a platform where I can expose other girls, and I feel like it's very necessary to widen the representation through the STEM fields rather than it simply being a male-dominated field.
At MSI, Gaynor Hall, WGN News.